Yo, what's happening, plant fam? Ian again with Extension's Youth Horticulture Education Program. And now that we're heading into summer season, I'm going to show you how to beat the heat with some easy-to-do indoor gardening projects that you can do from the comfort of your own home with easy-to-find and upcycled materials. This week's project, a 2-liter bottle self-wicking DIY hydroponic system. Hydroponics is a type of controlled environment agriculture that replaces plants' traditional soil-based needs with a nutrient solution, seen here in the bottom portion of this homemade unit, which supplies nutrition and water to the plant roots. It also requires an inert structural medium, seen here at the top, to provide support to the roots. You have probably seen pictures of fancy hydroponic units growing lettuce and tomatoes in a large-scale warehouse or greenhouse, but you can grow hydroponic herbs at home without the need for all that fancy equipment. In fact, for today's project, we are going to grow some cilantro in a hydroponic unit we'll make with only a 2-liter bottle, a 1/4-inch cotton cord, paper towels or napkins, and some scissors. Firstly, we are going to cut our 2-liter bottle, or equivalent, in half. As you can see from the different examples here, the exact type of bottle is not important. All that matters is that you have a tall, narrow plastic bottle with a cap that can be cut in half, and a hole drilled or cut into the cap. Next, we will cut our cotton wicking cord. You'll need about 2 to 3 feet so that we can wind the wick up the sides of the medium to ensure adequate water coverage of the root zone. Insert the cord through the hole that you made into the bottle cap, and then thread the cord into the bottle neck and screw the cap back onto the bottle. Next, pull the cord into the bottle so that only 1/3 of the cord is coming out through the top of the bottle cap. This is the part of the cord that we will place into the bottom half of the bottle containing our nutrient solution. Now we will make a small bed for our plant roots to grow into. Wind the cord around the inside of the top half of the bottle and fill the remaining space with your medium. You will need to choose something that helps the capillary action of the wicking system we are building, so select something fine with a lot of surface area. Some examples of media that you can try out are an inert seed starting mix like peat moss and perlite, finely ground coconut core fiber, expanded clay pellets, also known as hydroton, or even paper towels would do the trick if you are short on options. Be sure that if you are using paper towels that you stuff enough in there so that when they get wet they don't shrink up into nothing. The next step is to add a nutrient solution to the medium. Hydroponic nutrients are available at your local hydroponic store or online. To avoid hassle in your early experiments, I suggest using a powdered, mineral-based nutrient that dissolves into water easily. Get a nutrient with a higher nitrogen content for green leafy veggies and herbs because nitrogen is an important nutrient for producing the green chemical called chlorophyll, which is responsible for photosynthesis. Once you've pre-soaked your medium and added enough nutrient solution to your reservoir, or the bottom portion of your unit that contains the water, you are ready to add your seeds and starts. Here we have a tomatillo that was started from seed about 8 weeks ago. I find that, for hydroponics, cilantro seeds start more easily if I scour them with sandpaper or crack or crush the hard seed coat. Place your newly planted cilantro, tomato, or pepper start under a bright light or sunny window for 6 or more hours each day, and before the summer is up, you will have tomatillos, peppers, and cilantro ready for harvesting into a savory salsa or other delightful dish. Be sure to follow YHEP and other extension programs at facebook.com/UNRExtension.